Hello, I am Mrs. P. Radha, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science, Malala College for Women, Dindal. Today I am going to present on the topic SQL, the Structured Query Language. So, the overview of SQL, introduction, DDL commands, DML commands, SQL statements, operators, classes, aggregate functions. So, we are going to discuss on these topics. So first we will see what is a structured query language. The ANSI, American National Standard Institute, from the standard language, from the definition and manipulation of relational database. It includes data definition language, that is DDL, statements that specify and modify database schemas. It includes a data manipulation language, DML, statements that manipulate database content. Introduction. SQL is a structured query language. It is used to interact with the DBMS. It is a popular relational database language, first standardized in 1986 by American National Standard Institute. The basic structure of relational model is a table consisting of rows and columns. This definition includes declaring the name of each table to be included in a database, the names and data types of all columns of each table, constraints on the values in and among columns, and the granting of table manipulation privileges to prospective users. DDL commands, create table, it is used to create a table, alter table, modifies a table after it was created, drop table, removes a table from a database. How to create a table statement? So before you create a table, we must consider the type of the data, the table name, what column or columns will make up the primary key, the names of the columns. For example, create table statement syntax, that is create table, table name, then field 1 data type, within bracket we have to give not null, field 2 data type, so that is optional, not null and all, it's optional. So SQL attribute types, so the data types is numeric types, it is integer, floating point, formatted, and character string types, fixed length and varying length, bit string types, fixed length and varying length, date and time types, large types. In large types we have character and binary. Alter table statement, to add or drop columns on existing tables. Alter table, table statement, alter table, table name. Add attribute data type or drop column attribute. Example, create table food cart, that is the name of the table, in which I am giving two data types, that is three data types, date var character of 10, food var character of 20, and profit is float data type. So a table will be formed of date, food and profit. Now I am going to alter the table by introducing sold field. Alter table food cart, add sold int. So now a table will be formed with four fields, date, food, profit and sold. Now alter table food cart, now I am dropping the column of profit. So the table, in order to alter the table, alter table food cart, drop column profit. So now I will have a table date, food and sold. Now last drop table food cart, the table will be deleted. DML commands, insert, adds new rows to a table, update, modifies one or more attributes, delete, deletes one or more rows from a table. Insert statement, to insert a row into a table, it is necessary to have a value for each attribute and order matters. Insert into table name, values, within quotes value 1, comma, within quotes value 2, comma, null. Example, insert into food cart values 02/26/08, comma, then within quotes pizza, then comma 70. So date for date column and food in belonging to pizza will belong to the food field, and sold will be the amount to be added in the sold field. Update statement, to update the content of the table. Update statement syntax, update table name, set attribute equal to value. we can also give a condition where select condition. So update example, update food cart set sold equal to 349 where date equal to 2/25/08 and food equal to pizza. So in the below table we can see how it is updated. So this last row, that is 2/25/08, that pizza sold 350 is changed to 349, that is first row is changed to 350 to 349. Delete statement, to delete rows from the table, delete table name where condition, example delete from food cart where condition equal to hot dog. So in the existing table we have hot dog sold equal to 500. When I execute the statement, then the particular row will be deleted. SQL statements, operations and classes. SQL statement select, SQL operations join, left join, right join, like. SQL classes order by, group by, having. Basics statement includes three classes. So select attribute name from tables where condition. So select, this specifies the attributes that are part of the resulting relation. From specifies the tables that serve as an input to the statement. Where specifies the selection condition including the join condition. Then using a star in asterisk in select statement indicates that every attribute of the input table is to be selected. Example, select asterisk from table name, that is where a condition can be given. To get unique rows, type the keyword distinct after select. Example, select distinct asterisk from table name and where condition. Example, person, a table is created called a person, three fields, name, age and weight. So first when I give select asterisk from person where age greater than 30, then three rows will be selected. Then in the second query, select weight from person where age greater than 30, only the weight column will be selected. Select distinct weight from person where age greater than 30, here only two will be selected, that is from person where age greater than 30. Next, join operation. A join can be specified in the from class which lists the two input relation and the where class which lists the join condition. Example, we have two tables, emp and department, DEPT. So emp table has two fields, ID and state, and DEPT has two fields, ID and division. So inner join equal to join. So select asterisk from emp join DEPT or from emp comma DEPT on emp dot id equal to DEPT dot id. So this field must be unique in both the table. So emp id, emp state, then department id, department division. A new table will be created of joining the two tables. Then left outer join equal to left join. Select asterisk from emp left join DEPT on emp dot id equal to DEPT dot id. So it will be joined in the left side, that is emp dot id, emp state, emp id, then department division. Then right outer join equal to right join. Select asterisk from emp right join DEPT on emp dot id equal to DEPT dot id. So here we don't have an employee id with so the particular fields will be having the will be indicated with null values. The like operation, pattern matching selection, that is modulus, that is arbitrary string, select star from emp where id like, that is modulus 01. So this finds id that end with 01, example 1001 comma 2001 etc. Then underscore a single character, select asterisk from emp where id like underscore 01 underscore. This finds id that has second and third character as 01, example 1011. So likewise it will select the particular field. The order by class, ordered result selection. So this can be in descending order or in ascending order. So first descending order DESE, select asterisk from EMP, order by state DSC. So put state in descending order, example from example TN, MA, comma CA. ASC ascending order, select asterisk from EMP, order by ID. ASC puts ID in ascending order, example 1001, 1002, comma 1003. The group by class. The function is to divide the tuples into groups and return an aggregate for each group. Usually it is an aggregate function's companion. Select food, comma sum of sold as total sold from food cart, group by food. So the table food cart has three fields, date, food and sold. So by group by class we get a table of food and total sold, hot dog 500 and pizza 419. The having class, the substitute of where class, where for aggregate functions. Usually it is an aggregate function's companion. Select food comma sum of sold as total sold from food cart, group by food. Having sum of sold greater than 450. So only a particular row will be selected, that is hot dog of 500. Aggregate function. These functions are used to provide summarization information for SQL statement which return a single value. Count of attribute, sum of attribute, max, maximum of attribute, minimum, min of attribute and average AVG of attribute. Thank you.